Hello all, welcome to the lecture on the sequence data operations. So in the previous lecture we have seen what sequence data is and we have also seen how to create sequence data. For example, we have seen about creation of string, list, tuples, dictionary, sets and range. And in this lecture we are going to see how we can perform some of the operations on a sequence data. For example, we are going to see how we can do indexing on a sequence data. So here let's see what indexing means first. So indexing just means accessing elements from your sequence data. So to access the elements you can use the square brackets, and to access any elements from the given sequence you should be knowing the index of it, because all the elements inside the sequence data will be arranged in a particular order and every element will have its own index. So if you want to access elements from the sequence data, then you should be knowing its corresponding index to access it from. So to access elements you can use the square brackets, and there are other methods that can be used to access in Python as well. Also we are going to look at a method called index, which can be used to find the position of a given element. For example, the index method finds the first occurrence of the specified value and it is going to return its position. If an element is occurring multiple times in your sequence data, then it is going to give you the index for the first occurrence alone. So let's see how to use the index method. So you can apply this index method on any object, on any sequence data. So for example, I've given the syntax here to use the index method. So you can give the substring inside the index method. We will see an example on how to use the index method as well. You can also use the square brackets to access the elements from a given sequence of data, and you can give the index inside the square bracket. So it is going to give you the element corresponding to the given index. And as we know that index of an element is used to access an element from ordered sequences. So in Python, generally the indexing starts from 0. For example, if you want to access elements in an ordered sequence, then you can use the index starting from 0. So the first element has the index 0. But in a case where you want to access elements in the reverse order, for example, if you want to access elements from the end of a list, then you can look for negative indexing, where the negative indexing starts from minus 1. For example, the last element in an ordered sequence will have the index minus 1. Correspondingly, the second last element will have the index minus 2. So let's see how to index an element from a string. So basically, we've already created a string called strsample, which has a string as learning. So in the previous lecture, we've already seen how to create a string. So I'm just using the same example, so I'm going to take you through an example on how to index or how to access elements from the particular string. So I have already a str sample string. So now I am trying to use the index method to find the index of the substring L from the string. So the output is 0 since the index of the L is 0. For example, if you're trying to give sequence of values inside the function index, then it is going to give you the index of the first letter of your substring. So here ning is a substring from the original string learning, and I've given that as a sequence here, but the output is 4. The 4 corresponds to the index of the value n here. If you look at n in the learning string, index corresponding to n is 4. So that is the output that we are getting here. But if you want to find the substring corresponds to the given position, then you can use the square brackets. So I am using the square brackets followed by the string name strsample. I have given the index as 7. So it is going to give me an element which corresponds to the 7th index, which is nothing but G. For example, if you want to find the substring that corresponds to the second last position, for example, I am accessing the substring from the end of a string, then I can use the negative indexing. So I've given minus 2 and the output is n, because the second last element of the string is n. And if I try to give minus 9, then it is going to throw me an error saying index error string index out of range, because if you want to access the last element, then the index corresponding to the last element is only minus 8. We don't have any element which corresponds to minus 9 at all. So if you are trying to give an index which is out of range, then it is going to throw you an error. So here we have seen how to find the index of a substring using the index method, and we have also seen how to find the substring corresponds to the given position, that is given index. And we have also seen how to find the substring corresponds to the given index using the square brackets. Similarly, you can apply this onto any sequence data. For example, we can apply this on a list, array and other sequence data. So, let us see a few examples on how we can use this on other sequence data. So, here I am just going to illustrate you the indexing part using the list sequence data. So, syntax is given here, you can use the list name and you can use the index function. And inside the function, you can just give the element for which you want to find the position. So, I have already created a list called list LST sample, which has few elements to it. It has both numbers and strings. And to find the index of the element sam, I can use the index method, and inside the method, I can just give the element sam. So, that gives me an output 3, because the index corresponds to sam is 3. The index corresponds to 1 is 0, and the index corresponds to 2 is 1, and the index corresponds to A is 2, and the index corresponds to Sam is 3. But if you are going to find the element corresponding to a given index, then you can get that using square brackets. So, let us just try that. I am using list sample of 2 inside the square bracket. So, it is going to give me an element which corresponds to the index 2, which is nothing but A here. Similarly, you can access any elements from the end of a list as well using the negative indexing. So, if I give list sample of minus 1, then it is going to give me the last element of the list, list sample. So, which is nothing but 2. So, similarly, we can perform the indexing on an array. So, we have already seen how to create an array. So, let us just use the same example. So, I have printed out the values of array. The array sample has values 1, 2, 3 and 4. So, here I just have an example to show you how you can perform the negative index on this array. I am accessing the third last element of the array. So, it is going to give me the value 2, which is nothing but the third last element of the array. And similarly, we can perform that on a tuple. So, you can use the index method to find the position of the given element. So, let me just use py. So, the index of py is 5. So, here I am just trying to find the element which corresponds to the second index, which is 3 here. So, let us see how the indexing works in set. So, we have already created a set sample which has example 2487.5, data 24 and data as elements to it, and I am trying to use an index called 4, which gives me an error saying set object is not subscriptable, which means that you can't perform the indexing operation on a set. As we know that set is a container to hold non-sequential data, you won't be able to access the elements inside the set using indexing. So, next we are going to see how we can perform indexing on a dictionary. So, the Python dictionary object provides a key value pair facility. So, the values in the dictionary are indexed by keys and they are not held in any order. So, if you want to access the values from a dictionary, or then you can access them by using their keys. So, we have a dictionary called DictSample, which we have already created, which has keys as 1, 2nd, 3 and 4, and it also has a key value corresponding to it. For example, 1st, 2, 3 and 4. So, now let us see what happens when you are trying to access an element using a index. I am using an index say for example that is 2, it gives you a key error that is 2, as we know that values in a dictionary are indexed by keys. So you will be able to access them using keys, not using the index. So now I am using a key inside my square braces. So I am going to get a value corresponding to the key, that is 1. So the value corresponding to the key 1 is first. And as we know that key can either be a string or an integer value. So key can either have string as well as an integer. So here I have a key called second. So I'll be able to access a value corresponding to the key second. So I am getting an output as 2. So the value corresponding to key second is 2. So the last one is an example which is, so the last one is to illustrate you the indexing using a range. So we've already created a range sample which contains the values 1, 5 and 9. So you should be using an appropriate value which is already there in your range. If you are trying to give you a value which is not in the range, then it is going to throw you a value error. We are trying to check the index corresponding to the value 0, but in our case the range sample doesn't have the value 0 at all because it has only the values 1, 5, 9. In that case it throws a value error, so it says 0 is not in range. But if you are trying to find the position of the given element, that is 9 here, you will be able to do that because we already have a range value that is 9 and it gives you the position of that particular element, that is 2. And we can also get the element given the index. So I've given the index as 1. So it gives the output as 5 because the index corresponding to the value 1 is 0 and the index corresponding to the value 5 is 1. But if you are trying to give the index which is out of range, then it is also going to throw an error saying index error because you have an error in the given index. That is why the error says it is index error and saying range object index out of range because you don't have any element corresponds to the index 9. That is why the error says index error. So in this lecture we have seen, how to get the element given an index, and we've also seen, how to get the element given the index inside the square brackets, and we've also seen how to use the index method to find the position of the given element. We've seen the indexing in all the sequential and non-sequential data, and in that case we have seen how to perform the indexing on a sequential data, and we won't be able to perform indexing on a non-sequential data since the values inside the non-sequential data are not held in any particular order, so we can't access them using indexing. And when dictionary is concerned, even though it is a container for non-sequential data, you will be still be able to access the values inside your dictionary using keys. The values in a dictionary are indexed by keys, not by any index. So in the upcoming lectures, we will be seeing more operations that we can perform on the sequence data. Thank you.